Okay, I think only the front row. Is anybody in the back ready for the word? Get ready for the word. Give God praise. Let's do a wave. Well, I'm going to preach today. I've asked Pastor Lynn, amen, to bring the word today. Just want to give you a quick word. Hallelujah. Quiero darte una palabra. About 4 years ago, I believe, I met Pastor Lynn at Office Depot, out of all the places. And he did not look like Pastor Lynn looks right now. He had long hair.
Long hair.
And it was black at that time. So I don't know what happened from now to. But we met up and I invited him. I said, we're having service tomorrow morning. You guys are more than welcome to come with him and his son. And he accepted the invitation. Little did I know that he was married to Sister Kim, whom Sister Kim, I've known her since, I guess we got here to Seguin in 85, 86. We were young, and I was able to meet, she became a part of the family. Amen. Her uncle married my sister, so we got connected somehow. Amen. And then we didn't see each other no more. And then I met Pastor Lynn at Cavco, and he wasn't Pastor Lynn. He wasn't walking good at all. At all. I knew who he was because I had met him one time. But what I'm telling you today is the growth and the thing that God has done in his life, lo que Dios ha hecho en su vida. How far he's come, how far his wife has come. His wife was a Catholic all her life till she met Jesus. She had religion until she met Jesus. Tenía religión hasta que no encontró a Jesús. And I want to thank the Lord because Pastor Lynn and Pastor Kim have been one of our faithful ones here at the church. They've been with us through thick and thin, and there's some other ones that have been also with us here. But I want to honor him today, quiero honrarlo, and I want to tell you, Pastor, that I thank you so much for you and your wife. You know, I tell Pastor Lynn, Pastor, can you bring a word? Like, yeah. He has never said no. He's like, I'll bring a word. And I want to thank the Lord for him, and he's been there, with us. And he's going to bring the word. And I know he's got a good word today. And all I'm asking you is for you to open up your heart to receive what the Spirit of God is going to speak today. Abra su corazón a lo que el Espíritu va a hablar en esta hora. Amen. So are you ready? I know we do this with a lot of ministry, but can we stand to our feet and welcome, hallelujah, Pastor Lynn, hallelujah, as he brings the word today. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. God is good.
Dios es bueno.
As I was preparing this word,
mientras estaba preparando esta palabra,
Pastor had asked me last Sunday if, you know, that maybe I might be preaching today.
El pastor me dijo la semana pasada que iba a traer la palabra hoy.
And there had been some stuff we've been going through as a family and with each other, with my wife and myself.
And cosas han estado sucediendo entre mi familia, entre mi esposa y yo.
And this has never happened before.
Y esto nunca ha sucedido antes.
But as I was putting this word together,
mientras estaba poniendo, alistando esta palabra,
and as God was revealing the scriptures to me,
Dios me estaba revelando las palabras, mientras me revelaba las palabras,
as I was reading and studying,
leyendo y estudiando,
it began to minister to my heart,
empezó a ministrar a mi corazón,
and it began to expose me to stuff that I had never seen before in my life.
Y empezó, empezó a exponer cosas en mi vida que yo no había visto antes.
And throughout the week,
a través de la semana,
on Wednesday night,
el miércoles,
Pastor brought a powerful teaching.
Trajo una palabra el pastor poderosa.
And once again, it ministered to my heart.
Y ministró a mi corazón una vez más.
And it blessed me and Kim so much.
Y nos bendijo tanto a nosotros, a mi esposa y a mí.
And it was related, of course, it was confirmation to what I was preparing.
Y era una confirmación a lo que yo estaba preparando.
And the past few days, same thing. I was just getting confirmation.
Y estaba recibiendo confirmación estos últimos días.
And then this morning, as Pastor Rachel was leading praise and worship.
Y esta mañana cuando la pastora Raquel estaba aquí llevando a cabo la adoración.
And as she was testifying.
Estaba testificando.
Once again, she was all over my message.
Estaba mi mensaje una vez más.
But once again, that's just confirmation.
Y es solo confirmación.
Of what God wants to do this morning.
Lo que Dios quiere hacer esta mañana, amen.
So real quickly, I had a scripture I was going to open up with. I'm still going to read you that scripture.
Tenía una escritura que quería que voy a hablar.
I just want to praise God for a few seconds and give you this scripture real quick.
Quiero darte esta escritura y adorar a Dios por unos momentos.
And you don't have to go there. I'm just going to read it to you.
Usted no tiene que ir ahí, yo nomás se la voy a leer.
But it's in Psalms 124.
Salmo 124.
And it says, Psalm
124:1. 124:1 dice.
And it says, if it had not been the Lord who was on our side.
Si no fuera sido por el Señor que estaba de nuestro lado.
Let Israel say now say.
Que diga Israel ahora.
If it had not been the Lord.
Si no fuera sido el Señor.
Who was on our side.
Que estaba de nuestro lado.
In other words.
En otras palabras.
Had it not been for God.
Si no fuera sido Dios.
I don't know where I would be today, this morning.
Donde yo estuviera esta mañana.
If it had not been for God.
Si no fuera sido por Dios.
That car wreck would have taken you out of the picture.
Esa lucha, ese choque lo hubiera sacado a él.
If it had not been for God on your side.
Si no fuera sido Dios a tu lado.
Cancer would have taken you out.
Lo hubiera sacado.
If it had not been for God on your side.
Dios a tu lado.
That heart attack.
Ese ataque
would have taken you out.
Lo hubiera sacado.
Had it not been for God.
Si no fuera sido por
on
Dios.
Your side.
De tu lado.
You wouldn't be here this morning.
Estuvieras aquí esta mañana.
But God.
Pero Dios.
I said, but God.
Dije, pero Dios.
Is on our side
está
this
de nuestro
morning.
Lado esta mañana.
And because God.
Pero porque
is
Dios
on our side.
Está de nuestro lado.
Today.
Hoy.
We can praise Him.
Podemos adorar.
We can worship Him.
Podemos adorar.
We can call on His mighty name.
Y llamar su nombre.
We are alive.
Somos vivos.
And we are well.
Y estamos bien.
We worship you, Lord God.
Adoramos, mi Dios.
We thank you.
Te damos las gracias.
For being on our side
por
this morning.
Por estar de nuestro lado en esta mañana.
And what I want to talk to you about this morning.
De lo que quiero hablarte esta mañana.
What we had been going through.
Lo que hemos estado pasando.
Not about what we went through.
No lo que pasamos.
But how we dealt with it. How we dealt with it.
Cómo nosotros lo confrontamos.
This morning,
esta mañana,
I want to ask you,
quiero preguntarte,
who are you?
¿Quién eres tú?
In Christ,
en Cristo.
What does God truly mean to you?
¿Qué es lo que verdaderamente Dios quiere decir para
you
ti?
You can sit down.
Puedes sentarte.
I believe.
Yo creo.
As Christians, as men and women of God.
Como cristianos, como hombres y mujeres de Dios.
When we go through something.
Cuando pasamos por algo.
We tend to let that situation drag us too far down.
Dejamos que esa situación nos tumbe hacia abajo.
And sometimes we tend to climb up.
Y a veces tratamos de de escalar hacia arriba.
And we tend to blame God or get mad at him.
O echarle la culpa a Dios o enojarnos con Dios.
And sometimes we'll even go as far as leaving the church for whatever we're going through.
O a veces llegamos hasta el punto de irnos de la iglesia por cualquier situación.
Knowing very well that it's not God's fault.
Sabiendo muy bien que no es la culpa de Dios.
It's not God's fault.
No es la culpa de Dios.
On Wednesday,
el miércoles,
pastor said that we tend to treat God as if he's our spare tire.
El miércoles el pastor dijo que a veces tratamos a Dios como que si es la llanta, la extra que tenemos en la cajuela.
Only taking him out or coming to him when we need him.
Sacándolo, viniendo a él cuando él no lo necesitamos nada más.
And that's true.
Y eso es verdad.
But I also like to think.
Yo también quiero pensar.
That as Christians.
Que como cristianos.
We tend to use Jesus.
Tratamos de usar a Jesús.
As if he's our insurance policy.
Como nuestra aseguranza, nuestra póliza de aseguranza.
We only come to him when we need him.
Lo venemos a él cuando lo necesitamos.
We only cry out to him when we're going through something.
Solamente clamamos a él o lloramos a él cuando estamos pasando por algo.
When you have full coverage insurance.
Cuando tienes una cobertura total en la aseguranza.
You're able to pick and choose what policy you want.
Usted puede escoger cuál póliza usted quiere.
If you want collision.
Si usted quiere de accidente.
But you don't want insured or uninsured. You don't pick that.
Si usted no quiere que sea protegido por lo que no tiene aseguranza, no lo escoge.
Or you pick this and not that. You choose your deductible.
Usted escoge qué es lo que usted quiere.
And we treat Jesus the same way.
Y tratamos a Jesús de la misma manera.
We tell him, God,
le decimos, Dios,
I need you for this.
Te necesito para acá.
But for over here, I don't need you.
Pero acá no te necesito.
Lord, I need you for this.
Te necesito para
esto. But for this over here, Lord God, I can handle it.
Pero para esto acá yo puedo con él.
We tend to use Jesus.
Tratamos de usar a Jesús.
As our insurance policy.
Como nuestra póliza de aseguranza.
And he's not here.
Y él no está aquí.
To cover you in that manner.
Para cubrirte de esa manera.
He's not your policy. He's not.
No es tu póliza ni mi póliza.
He's a risen king.
Él es el rey que resucitó.
He is the Lord God Almighty.
Él es el Dios todopoderoso.
He is a faithful and just God.
Él es el Dios fiel y justo.
He is a loving God.
Él es un Dios amoroso.
So what I'm trying to get to this morning.
Lo que te quiero tratar de decir esta mañana.
Is when we go through something.
Es que cuando pasamos por algo.
Let's not throw in the towel.
No tire la toalla.
Let's not give up.
No se dé por vencido.
Let's not sulk and throw a pity party.
No te quedes ahí y empieza a llorar ahí.
Because it's in the middle of that situation.
Porque en medio de esa
situación. When we should praise God even more.
Cuando debemos de adorar a Dios
it's
más.
It's in that valley.
En ese valle.
In that darkness.
En esa oscuridad.
When we should call upon God. God is God.
Dios es Dios.
Every single time.
Siempre.
God is God when your lights are on.
Dios es Dios cuando
God tiene luz is God prendida. When your lights are off.
Cuando no tiene luz en su
God
casa,
is
Dios
God
Dios.
When you have cancer.
Cuando tienes cáncer,
and
Dios
God
Dios.
Is still God when you are free from cancer.
Y Dios es Dios cuando no
God
tiene
is God
cáncer.
In the middle of that situation.
Dios es Dios en medio
and
de la
God
situación.
Is God when you come out of that situation.
Y Dios es Dios cuando salga
God
de la
is God.
Cuando salga de la oscuridad, Dios es Dios.
God,
Dios
is faithful.
Es fiel.
And we should be faithful.
Y nosotros
as well.
Debemos de ser fieles también.
God didn't give up on us.
Dios no se dio por vencido en nosotros.
So we can't give up on him.
Nosotros no debemos de darnos por vencido tampoco en Dios.
Hebrews chapter 12.
Hebreos capítulo 12.
Verse 1.
Versículo 1.
It says.
Dice.
Therefore. We also, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which so easily ensnares us. Let us run with endurance the race that is set before us, looking unto Jesus. And there's the other versions say, fixed unto Jesus, our eyes being fixed unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and has sat down at the right hand of God, at the right, at the right, at at the right hand of the throne of God.
Es Dios fiel. Hebreos 12:1. Poniendo nuestra mirada en el Señor, el autor y consumador de nuestra fe.
Like I said, other versions say, having fixed our eyes on Jesus.
Otra versión dice, poniendo tu mirada en Jesús.
The definition fixed.
La definición para la palabra fijando.
Is firmly in position.
Firmemente en posición.
Determined.
Determinado.
Established.
Establecido.
Set.
Puesto.
Not subject to change.
Que no está sujeto a cambio.
But I think what our problem is.
Yo siento que nuestro problema es.
Is we tend to get discouraged and sidetracked.
Nos desanimamos y empezamos a desviarnos.
We tend to lose focus.
No tenemos el enfoque.
Of the author.
Del autor.
And the finisher.
Del consumador.
Of our faith.
De nuestra fe.
And when we go through something.
Y cuando pasamos por algo.
Because our eyes.
Porque nuestros ojos. No están puestos
on the author and the finisher.
En el autor y el consumador.
We're quick.
Estamos rápidos.
To want to give up.
Para darnos por vencido.
Or get angry.
O enojarnos.
And blame God.
Y echarle la culpa a Dios.
And we're quick.
Y somos listos.
To just blame God for whatever it is we're going through.
Echarle la culpa a Dios por cualquier cosa que estamos pasando.
But if we keep our eyes fixed.
Pero si ponemos nuestros ojos en Jesús.
We can face anything.
Podemos con cualquier cosa.
And that what we go through.
Y eso que pasamos.
We can handle it a lot much better.
Podemos nosotros con ello más fácil. Aleluya.
Listen.
Escuchen.
God never said.
Dios nunca dijo.
That it was going to be easy.
Que iba a estar fácil.
He died on the cross for us.
Él murió en la cruz por nosotros.
He did say it is finished.
Él dijo es consumado es.
But never.
Pero nunca.
Did he say.
Dijo.
The journey.
Que la jornada
to our salvation,
hacia nuestra salvación
the journey,
la jornada
when he finally comes back for
cuando
his church,
él venga por su iglesia
that it would be easy.
Que iba a ser fácil
no it will not be easy.
No va a ser fácil
but it's okay,
pero está bien
because as long
porque mientras
as we have each other,
que nos tengamos los unos
long,
a los otros
as God is on our side,
que Dios esté de nuestro lado
we have nothing
no tenemos nada
to worry about.
De que preocuparnos.
I wish I could stand up here and tell you
quisiera yo pararme aquí atrás y decirte
that we will never go through anything.
Que nunca vamos a pasar por nada.
But then, what would be the purpose of the cross?
¿Qué es el propósito de la cruz entonces?
We unfortunately have to go through things.
Debemos, vamos a pasar por cosas, mi hermano.
And we've got to understand, even though sometimes it might not be easy.
Y tenemos que entender que aun cuando no sea fácil,
we will endure. Amen.
Vamos a vencer. Amen.
Romans chapter 8 verse 31 says.
Romanos 8:31 lo va a leer en inglés.
What then shall we say to these things? God is for us. Who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but delivered him. For us all, how shall he not with him also freely give us all these things? Who shall bring a charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is he who condemns? It is Christ who died, and furthermore is also risen. Who is even at the right hand of God, who also makes intercession for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are killed all day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Once again, who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, should that trial, should that situation, should that sickness, should cancer, should diabetes, should that separate us from the love of Christ? No.
Nada nos separará del amor de Cristo. Tribulación, angustia, persecución, hambre o desnudez, dice, nada nos va a separar del amor de Cristo.
Nothing.
Nada.
Should be able.
Va.
To come between.
A venir en medio de ti.
And Jesus.
Y Jesús.
You.
Tú.
And your victory.
Tu victoria.
You.
Tú.
And your healing.
Y tu
amen.
Sanidad. Amén. Aleluya.
We should have
debemos de tener
the kind of faith,
la fe, la clase de fe,
the faith, the kind of faith that testifies,
la clase de fe que testifica
to other people,
a otra gente.
Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego.
Meshach, Shadrach, y Abednego.
They had the kind of faith that we should all have.
Ellos tenían la fe que nosotros debemos de tener.
A faith.
Una fe.
That set them free.
Que los hizo libres.
That delivered them.
Que los liberó.
Even before they were thrown into the fiery furnace.
Aún fueran tirados en el horno de fuego.
I said even before they were thrown into the fiery furnace.
Aún antes de que fueran tirados al fuego.
I've read this story many times.
Leí esta historia muchas veces.
And I always thought.
Y yo siempre pensaba.
That God showed up.
Que Dios vino.
In the middle of the fire.
En medio del fuego.
That once they were thrown into the fire.
Cuando ellos fueron tirados al fuego.
I thought that's when God had showed up.
Yo pensaba que ahí es cuando Dios había venido.
But one day.
Pero un día.
God opened my eyes.
Dios abrió mis ojos.
To the scripture.
A las escrituras.
And this is what he showed me.
Y esto es lo que me enseñó.
This is what I learned.
Esto es lo que aprendí.
You don't have to go there.
No tiene que usted ir allí.
But Nebuchadnezzar, the king Nebuchadnezzar,
el rey Nebuchadnezzar,
he had built a golden statue or golden image.
Él había hecho una estatua de oro.
And the people came to him and said,
y la gente vino y le dijo,
Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego,
Meshach, Shadrach, y Abednego,
they're not bowing down to your golden image.
No se están arrodillando a tu imagen de oro.
And King Nebuchadnezzar was furious.
Y el rey estaba furioso.
He was angry.
Estaba enojado.
And this is what happened.
Y esto es lo que sucedió.
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
Los tres jóvenes hebreos.
Answer. Oh, I'm sorry. Let me go back a little bit. All right. Then Nebuchadnezzar, in large fury, gave the command to bring Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. So they brought these men before the king. Shadrach, or Nebuchadnezzar, spoke, saying to them, is it true, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, that you do not serve my gods or worship the golden image which I have set up? 15. Now, if you are ready at the time you hear the sound of the horn, flute, harp, and lyre, and psaltery, in symphony with all kinds of music, and you fall down and worship the image which I have made, good. But if you do not worship, you shall be cast immediately into the midst of a burning fiery furnace. And who is the God who will deliver you from my hands? Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego answered and said to the king, O Nebuchadnezzar, we have no need to answer you in this matter. If that is the case, our God, whom we serve, is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace, and he will deliver us from your hand, O king. And here's the response that we should all be responding to God. The three Hebrew boys, instead of complaining or being fearful, they said, but if not, let it be known to you, O king, that we do not serve your gods, nor will we worship the gold image which you have set up. Did you get that?
Si recibí eso, Daniel 3:15 en adelante.
In other words,
en otras palabras,
King Nebuchadnezzar told them,
el rey les dijo,
if you do not bow down to these golden images,
si no te arrodillas a estas imágenes de oro,
into the fiery furnace you will be cast.
Vas a ser arrojado al horno de fuego.
In other words,
en otras palabras,
your son,
tu hijo,
if you don't bow down to my God,
si no te arrodillas a mi Dios,
he will face affliction.
Él va a tener aflicción.
He will go through trials and tribulations that you don't
pruebas
want him to go through. Tribulaciones
que tú no quieres que ellos pasen.
But their response was,
pero su respuesta era,
so be it.
Que sí sea.
Whether God shows up or not,
venga Dios o no
we
venga,
will not bow down. Whether God shows up or not,
venga Dios o no,
so be it. I will serve God Almighty no matter what.
No importando qué.
In other words,
en otras palabras,
no matter what your son goes through, no matter what my child goes through, I'm going to praise God regardless.
Yo voy a adorar a Dios.
Quizás esté but praise
con
cáncer,
pero alabado sea Dios.
Because at the end of the day,
pero al final del día,
God will receive all the glory.
toda la honra y la gloria.
See, what we don't understand,
lo que no entendemos,
is this trial,
esta prueba,
this fiery furnace,
este fuego,
that we are facing,
el cual nosotros estamos confrontando,
it is not for us,
no es para nosotros,
but it's for the glory of God,
es para la gloria de Dios.
It is a testimony in the making.
Es un testimonio que está a punto de ser.
So instead of complaining,
en vez de quejarte,
endure the testimony.
Oh, pase por el testimonio.
Work on your testimony. Because if you have nothing to testify about,
no tiene nada que
then you ain't got no business in the presence of God.
No tiene ningún negocio en la presencia.
If you have nothing to test about,
y no tiene que
then it is not God's name that you are lifting on high.
Entonces no es el nombre de Dios que usted está levantando.
So the three Hebrew boys.
Los tres jóvenes hebreos.
In other words, they were telling King Nebuchadnezzar, bring it on.
Le estaban diciendo al rey, vamos, tráelo.
And King Nebuchadnezzar.
El rey de Nebuchadnezzar.
The Bible says that he got some of his strongest men.
La Biblia dice que trajo uno de sus hombres más fuertes.
And that they bound the three Hebrew boys.
Dice, y ataron a estos tres jóvenes hebreos.
And as they were, and Nebuchadnezzar, it says that he ordered the flame 7 times hotter than what it normally burns.
No, 7 veces más caliente el horno de lo que normalmente estaba caliente.
Watch this.
Mire esto.
As the band,
mientras los hombres
were bringing,
estaban trayendo
the Hebrew boys,
a los tres jóvenes hebreos,
to the fiery furnace,
al fuego.
My Bible says,
la Biblia, mi Biblia dice,
that the fire was so hot,
que el fuego estaba tan caliente,
that it burned up, it consumed,
que consumió,
Nebuchadnezzar's men,
los hombres del rey.
Come on.
Vamos.
So the three Hebrew boys confessed God before Nebuchadnezzar.
El momento que los tres jóvenes hebreos confesaron a Dios en frente del rey.
God had already showed up.
Dios ya había venido. Cuando los tres jóvenes hebreos
confess their faith to God,
confesaron su fe a Dios,
be as it may,
afuera lo que fuera,
whether our God shows up or not,
venga Dios o no venga,
do what you gotta do, Nebuchadnezzar,
rey.
We will not bow down,
no vamos
to this situation. So God had already shown up,
Dios se había venido,
because the fire,
porque el fuego,
before they came, before they were thrown into the furnace,
que fueran tirados al fuego,
the fire had already consumed the guards.
Aleluya, el fuego ya había consumido a los soldados, pero no a los tres jóvenes hebreos.
In other words, God was already at the scene.
Dios ya estaba en el escenario.
So next time,
así es que a la otra,
you get a bad report,
que usted agarre un reporte malo,
next time,
a la otra,
if God says,
si Dios lo dice,
that you have cancer,
que el doctor dice,
or diabetes, and I'm not speaking this, I'm just giving you an example.
Estoy dando un ejemplo.
Next time, if there is a bad report like that,
malo como eso,
all you've got to do is stand up in front of that doctor,
ponte enfrente de ese doctor,
and begin to prophesy,
y empieza a profetizar,
be so as it may,
sea lo que sea,
cancer might be coming this way, but I'm
going
to praise God regardless,
voy a adorar a Dios, van cortando.
I might be staring diabetes in the face,
quizás esté viendo la diabetes,
but my God,
pero mi Dios,
will heal me,
me va a sanar.
And all this,
y todo eso,
happening for the glory,
la honra y la gloria de Dios.
I'm going to begin working on my testimony.
Voy a empezar a trabajar en mi testimonio.
I will not complain.
No voy a quejarme.
I will not quit on God.
No voy a darme por vencido.
I will not leave the church.
No dejaré la iglesia.
Because God's been good to me.
Porque Dios ha sido
good to me.
Bueno conmigo.
Yes.
Yeah. Aleluya.
And the story goes.
Y la historia continúa.
Excuse me. As the story goes.
Mientras la historia continúa.
The three Hebrew boys were cast into the fiery furnace.
Los tres jóvenes hebreos fueron lanzados en el horno de fuego.
And my Bible says that.
Y mi Biblia dice.
The ropes.
Que las cuerdas.
Get this.
Mire esto.
The ropes.
Las cuerdas.
Which they were bound by.
Las cuales ellos estaban atados.
Were burned up.
Se quemaron.
But.
Pero.
The clothes,
la ropa,
their garments,
el lo que traían puesto,
that they were wearing,
que ellos tenían,
still intact.
Todavía estaba completo.
Who but God?
¿Quién más que Dios?
Who but God?
¿Quién más que Dios?
Can do something like that?
¿Hacer algo así?
Three boys,
tres jóvenes,
cast into the fire,
puesto ellos en el horno de fuego. Y lo único que se está quemando es lo que estaba atándolos. Pero ellos estaban completos. Y el rey miró.
And he said,
y dijo:
correct me if I'm wrong.
Corríjame.
But didn't we throw three people in that fire?
Tiramos tres ahí en el fuego.
Why is it then?
Porque entonces.
Did I see four?
Hay que hay cuatro.
And they're dancing. And they're shouting.
Supremo, aleluya.
My God,
mi Dios.
Glory to you, Lord Jesus.
Gloria a Dios, aleluya.
Powerful story.
Poderosa historia.
I've read this story many a times.
He leído esta historia muchas veces.
And I always thought God showed up in the middle of the fire.
Yo siempre pensaba que Dios había venido en medio del fuego.
But when you're faithful to God,
pero cuando eres fiel a Dios,
I said when you're faithful to God,
eres fiel a Dios,
He'll show up before the fire.
Él llega antes del fuego.
As a matter of fact, I'll go as far as saying that that fire that was burning in the furnace.
Y voy más allá y digo que ese fuego que estaba quemando ahí en el horno,
I believe at one point,
yo creo en un tiempo,
it was a natural fire burning.
Era un fuego natural.
But the second the Hebrew boys,
pero el momento que los tres jóvenes
confessed their faith to God, no matter what the outcome,
confesaron, aleluya, su fe,
that Dios, natural fire,
ese fuego natural,
became an all-consuming fire,
un fuego consumidor,
the fire of God,
el fuego de Dios, aleluya,
my Lord. We worship you, my King.
Te adoramos, mi
my God.
Mi Dios.
You are worthy, Lord God.
Tú eres digno, mi Dios.
Jesus.
Jesús.
Listen.
Escúchame.
Revelation 12:11 says.
Revelaciones 12:11 dice.
We have overcome him, the enemy.
Hemos vencido a él, al enemigo.
By the blood of the Lamb.
Por la sangre del cordero.
And the word of their testimony.
Y la palabra del testimonio.
By the blood of the Lamb,
la sangre del cordero,
and the word,
y la palabra,
of your testimony.
De tu testimonio.
If you have nothing to testify,
si no tienes nada que testificar de,
then you are not an overcomer. I'm
entonces,
sorry to
no
say.
Entonces no eres un vencedor. Perdón que te lo diga.
It's when you have that testimony.
Es cuando tengas ese testimonio.
Testifying means you've gone through something.
Testificar quiere decir que has pasado por algo.
And you came out of it.
Y saliste.
Despite what it was.
No importando qué lo que
maybe,
fue.
Yes, or maybe it was cancer.
Quizás sí era cáncer.
But today you're testifying.
Pero hoy estás testificando.
Maybe it was a heart attack.
Quizás era un ataque.
But today you're testifying.
Pero hoy estás testificando.
Yes, or maybe you came close to losing your liver.
Quizás
but today you're testifying.
Pero hoy estás testificando.
Yes, sir. Maybe you were involved in a car wreck.
Quizás estabas en un
and that car wreck almost amputated your leg.
Y haberlo te
but today you're testifying.
Pero hoy estás testificando.
Yes, sir. Maybe you were once lost, but today you're found. And
persona.
Now you're testifying.
Estás encontrado y puedes testificar.
Yes, sir. Maybe one day the enemy was after your children,
estaba
was after your daughter, but today you are testifying. And today you are more than an overcomer. Don't testify.
Porque testificamos.
Testify.
Testifica, aleluya.
And do not complain.
Y no te quejes.
Don't sulk.
Aleluya.
Don't throw that pity party because in the middle of that situation.
No te quejes porque
es when we should praise God even more.
Debemos de adorar más.
Oh, I know it's easy to praise God when everything's good.
Es fácil adorar.
I know it's easy to praise God when the lights are on.
Cuando la luz está.
I know it's easy to praise God when there's food on the
cuando
table.
Comida en la mesa.
But try praising God when you only got $5 to your name. Try praising God when you're facing death.
Cuando
when you're on your way to prison.
Empieza a adorar a Dios y tú vas a ver que Dios va a venir por ti en esa situación. Aleluya. Dele gloria al Rey de Reyes. Aleluya.
So we're not testifying.
So si no estamos testificando.
And we're not more than overcomers if we're not overcomers.
Y si no somos más que vencedores o vencedores.
Then what are we?
¿Qué es lo que somos?
Without God, we are nothing.
Sin Dios no somos nada.
Without God, it's impossible.
Sin Dios es imposible.
Without God,
sin Dios,
I don't know. I don't even want to think that.
No quiero ni pensar eso.
Without God,
sin Dios.
Those are words that we should cringe at.
Esos son palabras que debemos de rechazar.
Without God,
sin Dios.
Be a walking testimony.
Sé un testimonio andando.
Everywhere you go,
donde quiera que vayas,
let your lifestyle
Que tu estilo de vida,
let your appearance,
que tu apariencia,
let the way you walk, talk,
que la manera que tú hablas y caminas,
and look,
y te miras,
testify God's glory,
testifique la gloria de Dios.
Let people know,
haz que la gente sepa.
There's plenty of people out there.
Hay mucha gente allá afuera.
Let them know.
Hazles saber.
Testify to them.
Testifícales
what God has done in your life.
Lo que Dios ha hecho en tu vida.
Last scripture.
La última escritura.
You people ready to dance this morning?
¿Están listos para danzar esta mañana?
Are you ready to dance?
¿Están listos para danzar?
God is so good.
Dios está es tan bueno.
God is awesome.
Dios es maravilloso.
God is marvelous.
Dios es maravilloso.
God is beautiful.
Dios es hermoso. Aleluya.
God is faithful. Amen.
Dios es fiel. Amen.
In the middle of your situation.
En medio de tu situación.
Because once again, I wish I could stand up here and tell you that we ain't going to go through nothing.
Quisiera pararme aquí y decirte que no vamos a pasar por nada.
But we all know that's not true.
Pero sabemos que eso no es verdad.
But at least know.
Pero quiero que sepas.
That you can call on God.
Que puedes clamar a Dios.
Psalm 20.
Salmo 20,
6 through 9 says,
6 al 9 dice,
come on, stand to your feet.
Póngase de pie.
We're going to get ready to rejoice. We're going to get ready to dance.
Vamos a danzar, a gritar, a clamar a Dios.
Because God is good. God is
porque
faithful.
Dios es bueno, porque Dios es fiel.
God is all knowing.
Porque es un Dios que todo lo sabe.
Yes, God is all powerful.
Es todo poderoso.
And last night, Pastor Tim.
Y la noche, el pastor dijo.
He reminded us once again.
Nos recordó otra vez.
That Jesus said.
Que Jesús dijo.
That all power.
Que todo poder.
And all authority.
Y toda autoridad.
Has been given to me.
A
nosotros. And because Jesus lives in us, we walk in that same power, in that same authority. And there's no reason
y no hay razón
we should lack. There's no reason we should be defeated.
Derrotados tampoco.
Amen.
Amen.
You're worthy, Lord God.
Tú eres digno, Señor.
We worship you, my God.
Adoramos, mi Dios.
Psalm 20 and 6 says.
Salmo 20, versículo 6 dice.
Now I know.
Ahora yo sé.
That the Lord.
Que el Señor.
Saves his anointed.
Salva a su ungido.
Come on. Now I know.
Ahora yo sé.
That the Lord.
Que el Señor.
Saves his anointed.
Salva a su ungido.
He will answer him. He will answer him from his holy heaven.
Él le contestará de su santo cielo.
With the saving strength of his right hand.
Con la salvación de su mano derecha.
Some trust in chariots.
Alguien confía en carros de a caballo.
And some trust in horses.
Y otros en caballos.
But we will remember the name of the Lord our God.
Pero nosotros recordaremos el nombre de nuestro Señor.
They have bowed down and fallen.
Ellos se han alineado y caído.
But we.
Pero nosotros.
But we.
Pero nosotros.
Have risen.
Nos hemos levantado.
And stand upright.
Y nos ponemos de pie.
Say, Lord.
Sálvanos, Señor.
May the King answer.
Que el Rey conteste.
Us when we call.
Que el Rey nos conteste a nosotros.
I said, they have bowed down and fallen.
Aquellos se caen.
But we stand.
Pero nosotros nos paramos.
And we stand upright.
Y nos paramos derecho.
They have bowed down and fallen.
Ellos se han inclinado y caído.
But we have risen.
Pero nosotros nos hemos
and
levantado.
Stand upright.
Y estamos de
I say
pie.
We stand upright.
Estamos de pie.
Because we are sons and daughters of the
Porque
Most
somos
High.
Hijos y hijas del Rey.
Because we serve the risen God.
Porque servimos al Dios.
way.
Un Dios que hace camino donde no lo hay.
We serve a God that opens doors that man can't open.
Un Dios que abre puertas que un hombre no puede abrir.
We serve a God that tells us no when it's good for us.
Servimos a un Dios que nos dice que no cuando él sabe que no es bueno para nosotros.
We serve a God that's willing to show up in the fire with us.
Un Dios que está dispuesto a venir al fuego
con
nosotros.
We serve a God that protects us from the front and the rear.
Que nos protege de frente y atrás.
We serve a God that is our shelter.
Un Dios que es
nuestra cobertura. He's our covering. He's our everything. He's our fortress. He's our lighthouse. He's the lily of the valley.
Es el lirio del valle.
Oh, glory to God.
Toda gloria a Dios.
We worship you, my
God. Adoramos, mi Dios.
Listen.
Escúcheme.
In the middle of that situation.
En medio de esa situación.
During your next trial.
A través de tu siguiente prueba.
Make sure.
Por favor, tenlo por seguro.
That you begin to live God at all times.
Que tú empieces a adorar a Dios en todo tiempo.
God said, I will never leave you nor forsake you.
Nunca te dejaré ni te desampararé.
But when we don't confess His goodness,
pero cuando no confesamos su bondad,
He's still there.
Él está ahí como quiera.
Walk, just
camina,
walk that way.
Camina para allá.
If she's going through something, if she's in that valley and not proclaiming the name of God,
si ella va por este valle y no proclama el nombre del Señor,
God is still there.
Dios todavía está ahí.
But at a distance.
Pero a una distancia.
Watching her.
Viéndola.
Keeping an eye on her.
Poniendo su mirada en
making ella. Sure she's okay.
Que está bien.
Waiting.
Está esperando.
Waiting.
Esperando.
Waiting.
Esperando.
For that second.
Para ese segundo.
For that moment.
Ese momento.
When she's gonna come to her senses.
Cuando venga a sus
sentidos. And she begins to cry out.
Y empieza a clamar.
That she knows she can't do it without God.
No puede
and when
Dios.
She begins to confess God.
Y empieza a confesar
at
a Dios.
Moment,
en ese momento.
Is when He shows up.
Es cuando él viene.
And it's at that moment.
Ese momento.
When His faithfulness shows up. And He begins to
cierro.
Not that I want to go through something.
No que quiera pasar por algo.
But why don't we begin to prepare?
¿Por qué no nos preparamos?
For the next situation.
Por la siguiente situación.
The next trial.
La siguiente prueba.
Our next testimony.
Nuestro siguiente testimonio.
The enemy might be looking on.
Quizás el enemigo te esté viendo.
And he might know what's coming next.
Y quizás sepa lo que se viene.
He might know what trial you're fixing to face
quizás
next.
Sepa cuál prueba va a venir.
But why don't we blindside him?
Pero ¿por qué no venimos y
why don't we get him by surprise?
Y lo tomamos por
and
sorpresa.
The next situation we go through.
Y la siguiente situación
instead of complaining,
en vez de quejarnos,
we begin to praise God with everything we got.
Todo
I guarantee you that'll confuse the boots off that lying enemy.
Eso va a confundir al diablo mismo.
Situation,
en la siguiente situación o prueba.
Now we just begin to lift up the name of God. We begin to testify.
A testificar y
ahead of time. Amen.
Señor de
glory to God.
Hallelujah.
We worship you, Lord. God bless us.
Denle un aplauso fuerte al Rey de Reyes. Come on, somebody. Give God praise. Hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory.
What are you going to do the next time that you go through a situation? ¿Qué vamos a hacer? Vamos a adorar. We're going to praise God. No more complaining. I want us to tear up the invitations of the pity party. And let us make a new invitation that says rejoicing, praising the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Adorando al Rey de Reyes y Señor de Señores. ¿Cuántos dicen amén? Aleluya. Powerful word, aleluya. Powerful word, palabra poderosa de Dios. Gloria sea su nombre, aleluya. Dios es bueno, iglesia. God is good, church. God is good, amen, hallelujah. We're going to get ready to be dismissed. Vamos a ser despedidos. I want to let you know that next Sunday, say next Sunday.
Next Sunday.
Hallelujah. Next Sunday, we are going to have a nacho and Frito pie sale with drinks. It's a fundraiser.